Qinmin's coding is part of a long-term, bigger project she calls Red, a color that can be found in pretty much all she does, like the Apple Watch project, a simple but provocative campaign where she invites people to donate their Apple Watches to her, and in return, she'll give them a kidney. After seeing on the news in 2010 that a Chinese boy sold his own kidney to purchase Apple products, Qinmin got so intrigued, she decided to repeat the boy's behavior in an experiment.
Qinmin, your code project, as we were talking about before, is part of a bigger, more ambitious and longer project that you call Red. Mm-hmm. What is Red all about?
I feel like that's a color can represent my personality and my energy, so I just use red while doing painting, performance, and other kind of expressions.
Speaking of other kind of expressions, tell me about the Apple Watch project. Mm-hmm. I know that you got the idea for that after you read that a high schooler sold his kidney to get an Apple Watch, which is crazy. How did you go from reading that to turning that into what you turned into?
Yeah, because I start to develop the relationship between technology and art since 2012. Because I live in San Francisco, it's the center and it's the capital of the technology innovation. And a lot of artists have been kind of washing out of the working space because of technology. They want to move in and they can pay more than us. So it's always like a battle in San Francisco. And so I think that's kind of my situation and the things that artists in San Francisco have to face with. So I just have the motivation to do something with a relationship. It's not about saying kind of just negative stuff. I want to just ask him question, like why? And also I read the article from the Chinese news about the high school kid sold his own kidney for iPod. I mean, it's horrible, and why? So I kind of want to ask him the question, and I want to repeat his behavior to the public as a performance art presentation, and asking people to donate their Apple Watch to me, but it's I only accept the gold version because it's the most expensive, only for the rich people. And I mean, that's a purpose, and I will exchange my kidney, but not a real one. I will use different form.
What kind of kidneys have you been using? Like animals or?
No, so the picture I use, it's a pig kidneys.
Oh.
Because Chinese people, we eat kidneys, not the human kidneys, but I mean, the pig kidneys. And I love eat kidneys.
Uh-huh.
But so it's really funny and it's interesting to me, like kidneys. Because I know American people, they don't eat kidneys. So I will, So right now I'm preparing for the performance for that, for the Apple Watch project. And I want to do a dramatic environment, spatial, controversial, and complicated performance. Yeah.
What exactly do you want to convey with the whole entire project, basically, though? Because I know that you didn't want to criticize, per se, Apple or luxury goods. You wanted to focus more on the individual behavior.
Yes.
What exactly do you want to get out of it?
It's really hard asking why. Because when we make stuff, we think a lot of why.
Yeah.
But when we finish the project, it's a lot of response from the outside, from the public, and it's a conversation. It's ongoing conversation all the time. And that make me think another, the secondary why. And for me, because I'm interested in the study, research the human behavior and how the human behaviors have been influenced, shaped mm-hmm. by our big phenomena. So I think it's one of my research purpose. And also nowadays I'm thinking how I can combine the choreography into the fine art. And because I know a lot of artists, they use choreography, but they don't know what is choreography. But I see their work from my perspective. I love to see how the artists, how our thinking, how our thoughts can choreograph, can design the view, the work, can destroy the relationship between the audience, performer, the space, and objects, and all the kind of stuff, and then kind of collect all the parts and put it in the one. So I'm working on the philosophy artistically, yeah.